Okay. Welcome, everybody. How's everybody? Everybody, wait. Yeah. Okay. This is so awesome. Glad you are here. A little bit different than what we would typically do in Carson, but has some amazing things that I think are going to happen as a result of this. Our students have really, really stepped up. They have proven that they are flexible and adaptable, and as professionals, young professionals, that's going to be key as their careers ebb and flow, and great artists are able to ebb and flow with the times, because the most important thing is their development at this stage, and as they get out into the world, the most important thing becomes their ability as artists to continue to grow and develop and innovate. And those are step-by-step processes that we hope that we are teaching them. This exercise and what has happened as a result of the pandemic has brought forth some of the best in people, in that they had to adapt and they had to make some changes, and we were not willing to sacrifice the learning outcomes for our students. And my able faculty, who you see here, are very resilient people, very creative people, and we never say die. So we figure stuff out. And in so doing, we hope that our students will model some of that behavior as they did. And even though it was a little rough going at first, I think what has come out of it and what you'll see with this freshman class, particularly as a first year class, is the idea of trust, the idea of learning more about personal responsibility, and the idea of understanding that sometimes the script that you write is going to change. And when it does, sometimes there are things on the other side that are actually good for you, better for you, and offer you a little bit more skills than you would have maybe amassed had everything gone just perfectly. So we've already seen some of our professors. I'm going to introduce to you Chris Sampson, who you can see, who is the founding director of this program. You've been hearing and talking with Sean Holt, who is also one of our performance instructors. Professor Paul Jackson Jr. is here. Adriana Bollock, Professor Bollock, thank you for coming out. Nick Stubis, I see you. And I also see Professor Tim Kobza. And I'm sure there'll be some other people that I'm leaving out right now that we can talk to later. But the idea here is that this is a community. And in this community, it's a village, and it takes a village to do what we're doing. So thank you again for coming out. Couple of little things. You're already doing it. When you come online, you mute yourself so that the noise in your particular space doesn't impact everyone else's enjoyment. We don't hear you until you turn off your mute. And when you want to clap, let us see you. There's even like a reaction button down there if you want to do it digitally. We may ask you to open your mic, especially students. There you go, Austin. Especially students, if we would like for you to introduce the people who were in the band that we may have just seen or are about to see. So just be aware of that. This is going to sound so much better if you guys use headphones. If you are able to, and you got either these little guys or something like this, it's gonna sound that much better. So feel free, if you can, to use headphones. If not, whatever system that you're listening on, we hope you enjoy it. Okay, we've got four bands for you to hear today. And the music that they've been working on, the repertoire that they've been working on now, takes us through the 60s, gets us to the Flower Children, and gets us into the British Invasion. So you're gonna hear music from James Brown. You're gonna hear music from Sly Stone. You're gonna hear the Beatles. You're gonna hear the Zombies. And our students have done a great job in their deep dive of this music and in taking away from it the vocabulary and the excitement, and understanding the trajectory of this music helps them better understand where they are on this in this lineage. And we know that it's gonna make a difference for them in years to come. Okay.
My file
shifted. Huh? I heard somebody. What? Okay, mute yourself. About to go. All right. If we're okay, without further ado, I'm going to mute myself. And we're ready. These bands are going to come in They're just called band one, band two, band three, band four for no particular reason. We're going to start with band two. Band two. Here we go.
Patrice, would you prefer that I come back after every song for now?
I think in this one, maybe we can.
Okay.
Yeah, just to make sure everything's working.
Good deal.
Okay.
Yeah, I got a package notification. I haven't picked it up yet.
Oh, here's what's important for you to know about that. The students are not in the same time. So not only do they have to know their part, but they got to know the other person's part in order for it to work so that our enjoyment of them playing as an ensemble is still met. That was one of the big challenges of doing it and working in this modality, and they learned a lot. Great job. Let's keep going.
Patrice, this may be a good time to ask if everybody's hearing.
Yes.
Is technically everybody getting the music on their end and receiving everything okay? Okay,
all
great.
Right, sounded good. Okay, excellent. All right. Thank you. Council. Yay. Wow. Any questions from anybody so far? Comments? Maybe some of, a couple of you in the band can talk about what this felt like, this process. Anybody? Tippy, go.
I mean, this song is like such an iconic Etta James song, so it was really wonderful to get to perform it with the lovely folks that have been in my band this semester. So yeah, it was just a great process, and I'm happy to have been able to sing it.
Can one of you guys tell us everybody who was in your band and band members, wave or something so that we can all see you and acknowledge you?
Yeah, so we're band two. I'm Lizzie. I did vocals in this band with Tippy Ballady and Hannah Abraham. And then we had David McInnes on drums. We had Ted Friedman and James Sinigaliano on keys. And we had Brian Graben on bass and Aiden Rodriguez on guitar.
Excellent. We're going to hear one more from them. Sure, yes.
I have a question.
Yes.
Could I find out the process? Who went first with the tracks and then it got passed on to stuff? How did it work?
It was different at different times. One of you want to speak to what you did in your band this time?
Yes, for our band, we actually had one of our members, Aiden, who's a blessing. He would make click tracks for us. Like, we would have a meeting, decide how we wanted to end each song, and then Aiden would put together a click track for us and send it out to all of us, and we would play to it and record ourselves individually, and then we'd send it to one person, either Aiden or whoever was MD, and we'd throw it all together in a Logic session and mix it, or Ableton. Aiden uses Ableton. yeah, and then throw it all together.
Thanks a lot.
All right. Thank you, Dan. Let's have one more from this band.
I'm admitting just a few other people here. Patrice, give me one back.
Sure. From the rhythm section standpoint, or at least from drumming, like, I've never really got used to recording my playing and how that sounded. And so it was kind of a new adventure that I wasn't expecting to go on, and I'm sure the other members in my band could say the same on recording yourself and how you sound and how you project yourself and how to get that across without with high quality and making it sound good. So that was a new learning experience for us, for sure.
It's definitely weird, like, not being able to vibe off of each other's energy while playing. So being able to encapsulate the energy and the vibe of each song on your own is really just a task within itself. So this was a really cool learning process for that.
Fantastic. You guys will find yourself doing more and more of that because you'll be recording with people from all over the world, and sometimes there won't be the opportunity for you to be in the same room. And actually, the art of recording, even when you're in the same space, you're so divided for sound quality purposes typically, that to be able to have absorbed how to make it feel that it's together is a big part of what the recording art is all about as musicians. Great job. All right, can we try one more?
Here we go.
All right.
Let me be myself again. in the face. Cha-cha-cha, driving. Steppy in the face. Thank you for the party, but I could never stay. Many things is on my mind. Words in the way. I want to thank you for letting me be myself again. Thank you for letting me be myself again.
Way to go, band two.
I'm glad I have, like,
I'm gonna dance along to everyone. Okay,
that was awesome. That was awesome. All right, we're about to go to band three. Let me have the members of band three. Can you raise your hands? Hey, you don't remember who's in band three?
Yes.
Okay.
In three, we have, you got me up here? Yeah.
Yeah.
We have Charlie, Sam, Bella Vance, Stuart, Paige, Savannah, Garris, and Cordelia.
All right, here we go.
Right, and I can be wrong. My own beliefs are in my Yes, yes.
This is a lot of fun. Mm-hmm. A bunch of guys go, hey guys. Every day, hey guys.
All right. Good job, you guys. I love your costumes.
Shall we go back to number two, song two, Patrice?
Yes, please.
All right.
We had a question?
Yeah.
Was there a question?
With the question, unmute your mic, please.
Yeah, I was wondering, who played drums on that?
Just now?
Yeah, just now.
That's Charlie Rube. Right, Charlie?
What, Charlie, was he wearing pajamas?
Yes.
I'm mad. That's what I'm talking about. Roll out of bed and start funking. That's what I'm talking about. That was fantastic. Pajamas and sunglasses. Kill it.
My sound is working. Oh, there we go. Okay, I am working.
Yeah, okay, so the outfit really extends beyond just what you can see, okay? So there were pajama bottoms, okay? Then there was like a flannel midsection. I was wearing a red bow tie on every song, sunglasses, and sweat guards on the side that are American flag color.
Absolutely killing.
Thank you very much.
Yes, showtime, that's what I'm talking about, wonderful.
Nice job, you guys. And that's the idea, is that this is a performance class. And so part of what you're doing in this ensemble is learning the tradition and learning this music and learning your vocabulary, but also finding ways to make it organic to yourself and find ways to express yourself, even in the way you go about it, even the look on your face, even the clothes that you wear, the things like that that reflect your understanding of the music. It doesn't make a difference if you can't play, but since you can, it really enhances everything that you're about. This brought some new technical challenges for you guys too, in terms of being able to put things together, and the mixes become really important because our perception, as you can tell, is very, 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 very keen on what the mixes sound like. And when each person is playing and not with the other person, you've got to keep that under consideration in terms of your touch, especially your feel and your attitude. And the way you go about that informs the next person in line. So kudos to you guys, because I know that these are things that you hadn't ever had to deal with or thought about before when you're standing just a few feet from somebody. That's a lot easier. So congratulations for a good job. Let's move to your last one, the zombies. Nice job. Really good. Really good.
I've got a question on that one.
Okay.
For the band, I'm curious if the bass and the guitars, or even the rest of the rhythm section, if they were just listening to like the drums and the click, or if they had the track in their ears.
Yeah, so the way we did it is everyone played to the track, like the original song, and then we had clicks at the beginning and end, which would mark intros and outros, but everyone was playing to the original track.
Matt, you will remember that the Zombies track, is it goes up and down too, remember? You played this.
Yeah, it's faster in the chorus.
And so the idea of them all having to keep up with that, I think, was the way they attempted to, they opted to say, well, let's play and use their timing rather than try to find, make a click and play to that. You guys were given the options. The idea is that your method comes out of what you need to do the music. That's the lesson.
That's very tricky to do in this context too, to beat up on the chorus and bring it back down on the verse.
Good job, you guys. Yeah. Let's go to band four. Did we have any other questions, by the way, before we go on to band four? All right, let's go to band four.
To get up and do my thing.
Go ahead.
I want to get into it, man, you know, like a sex machine, man.
Yeah.
Doing it, you know.
Yeah.
Well, can I count it
off? Go ahead.
1, 2, 3, 4. Get up.
Get on up.
Get up.
Get on up.
Stay on the scene.
Get on up.
Like a sex machine.
Get on up.
Get up.
Get on up.
Get up.
Get on up.
Stay on the scene.
Get on up.
Shake your arm, then use your paw. Stay on the theme, like a sex machine. You got to have the feeling, sure as you're born. Get it together, right on, right on. Get up,
get on up.
Get up,
get on up.
Get up,
get on up.
Thank you.
shake your money maker. You 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 shake your money maker.
I just want to add something. I haven't spoken yet. Jamelia, to watch you come out of yourself, the year has been amazing. Good job on that.
Excellent work, you guys. Not easy to do, and you made it look so much fun. Let's keep going.
She loves you, yeah, yeah, yeah. She loves you, yeah, yeah, yeah. She loves you, yeah, 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 yeah. You think you lost your love? Well, I saw her yesterday. It's who she's thinking of. And she told me what to say. She said she loves you. She almost lost her mind, but now she says she knows you're not the hurting kind. She said she loves you, but you know that can't be bad. Yeah, she loves you, and you know you should be glad. Ooh. You know you should be glad. You know it's up to you. I think it's only fair. For I can hurt you too. Apologize to her. Because she loves you. And you know that can be bad. Yeah, she loves you. And you know you should be glad. With a love like that, you know you should be glad. With a love like that, you know you should be glad.
I want to give Caleb on that with that hi-hat, boy. Woo! Excellent. Excellent job. Excellent job. You guys sounded really great.
Thank you.
Yes.
Hi-hat! Woo!
Hi-hat, I'm telling you. That's hard to do. Excellent job. Will one of you please introduce the other members of the band before we go on?
Yeah, sure. I'll introduce it.
Okay.
So, my name is Austin Brown and I played bass. We had Caleb Tishburn on drums. We have Sam Victoria on guitar. We have Maria McMillan on the keys. And then our singers are Ellie Williams, Jamelia Johnson, and Mariah Quintero.
Thank you, Austin. Excellent. There was a question, I thought. Did somebody, Tim, unmute.
Sorry. Hey, question to the drummers. Are you guys recording your drums through the microphone on the iPhone, both of the drummers so far?
No, I'm recording directly into, I'm just using GarageBand right now, and then I'm mixing the, I mix the audio with the video, and then I drop that in.
OK, couple mics?
Yeah. Two overheads, a kick and snare.
Sounds great.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
I've actually only been using my iPhone.
Okay. Yeah.
That being said, I had to scramble to get an iPhone for class. But right. Once I started using it, I've only been using an iPhone.
Yeah, it's working. It's working. Good balance on your kit. Really good, guys. Thanks.
Along those lines, you know, that is one of the things that they had to experiment a little bit with, where to put the phone or where to put the mics in order to balance, to get a decent balance of the drums. And everybody had to do that. We learned mic techniques using the little thing on the mic from your headphones, how far away to be. It was all kinds of other things that came out of these lessons that forced them sort of into having to have a consciousness of a little bit more about production and how they were going to actually get their points across, given that they had limited tools on purpose, because we wanted everybody to participate. So this was not about using a DAW. It was not about using a digital audio workstation, is what that stands for. This was not about remixing. This was not about being able to have a perfect performance that you could cut and paste and put everything just right. This was about limited tools, being able to know the music, get inside the music, pull the music apart, deconstruct and reconstruct in the context of being able to come into performance class with these videos, since we couldn't be all together, and we would critique the videos just like we would if we were all together, for certain kinds of performance identification and markers that let us know that they were inside the music. A lot of beautiful things happened as a result, like that, like placing mics and things like that, that don't typically come out of that particular class when we're all together. So there were some added benefits. We lost a couple of things, but we gained a couple of things. So thank you guys also for being adaptable and being flexible. That's a big, big deal. Let's go on to you guys. Last one.
Thank you.
Everybody, nice job, man. Any questions? I'm sorry, I couldn't hear you. Who has a question? Nope, all good. Well, guys, I have the pleasure of being able to coach teach this class with Andy Abad, and we have a great time. We work really, really hard to try to continually figure out exactly what needs to happen in order for our students to be able to embrace this music as being their own. And Andy knows the music inside out, the music that we've chosen. There are lessons in every song. This is not just about, we pick some songs at random and you guys will learn them and you'll play them because they're cool. They're cool songs, but in each one, there's some obstacles. There's some things that they have to get together. And so the idea of being able to do this and make it look so much fun is because they're drilled down on very, very, specifically for those kinds of lessons. So Andy, I want to give a shout out and allow him to go ahead and talk and introduce our last band.
Great. Well, first I want to thank Patrice and the entire music faculty. We talked a lot, had a lot of meetings about how we could make this happen and what it was all going to look like and what all the ins and outs. And Sean, who's with us running the show today, he was very key role in this. But everybody, the entire faculty, you know, you all are here, and thank you so much for all your input to make this happen. A couple things that are kind of obvious. This is the first semester where the entire semester, every single song was done remotely, because we, you know, obviously when we came back from the break, we never got to be in a classroom together again. So I think they did an amazing job. So I want everybody, just if you're not unmuted, just come on, give me a big hand and big applause for this class. That did an amazing job. Now, some of you that have been in the class before or that will know that for each final, we have final or midterm, we'll do anywhere from three, sometimes up to five songs. And generally everybody gets a lead vocal on there. And then when we get to the last quarter, a lot of these songs are gang vocals where everybody sings. So there are fewer people that get a lead vocal song. And because this year, because how difficult it is to do three songs and get it turned in for a week, I didn't want to add more songs, so we kept it at three. So some of our amazing singers did not get lead vocals songs, like Lizzie Cameron, who else? Ellie, those of you that didn't get a song, it had nothing to do with your performance. It was just a matter of, we need to get a show and I need to put the show together with the best flow and be as fair as we can. So I just want to let you know that if you didn't get a song, nothing against your performance, because everybody was amazing on this. Another thing, so the industry in general has been moving more and more towards social media for lots of things. The drummer for Josh Groban, which is a really posh gig to have, is an internet drummer who actually never played with the band before. He was just an internet guy, and he got that gig because the artist loved his videos. And a lot of people are using them for auditioning. You'll be able to audition across the country via, now I guess via Zoom, you know? So this skill that you learned to do this time, how to play and give the energy by yourself in your room, make it feel like you're in a band, and how to sell yourself, be present in the moment in the camera, is exactly where the industry is going. So this has been a great tool. And I just want to say, pleasure working with you. You know, every week we have a little safety measure, which is you send me your rehearsals and I'll give you all the notes to come back into class. And then after this year, you guys are on your own, but you're well trained and you know exactly what to do. So I'm not worried about any of you. So I just want to say it's been a great pleasure teaching y'all, and I'm so proud of all the incredible progress and growth that I've seen in you. That's nothing makes me happier than to see that. This last band, they made a compilation. This is band one, and Zoe was our MD for this band. She's on the keys, and they made a little beginning to end, so it's got like fade with the title. So I'll just see you on the other side of this, and then we can have our final say, and I'll have Zoe, you can introduce your band at the end there. Ready, Sean?
Summer day, oh summer day. It's true.
Fair in the countryside,
and everything is true.
With a few friends because
we never talked about a percentage like how
guys
so who did I say was Zoe, you're the MD.
We're gonna have Will introduce the band and everything.
Okay, go Will.
So that was Becca on drums, I play bass, Alex Shaw is playing guitar, Michael Campanelli sings, plays guitar, Zoe, Levine, and Isabella were playing keys, Kendall, Michael, and Isabella were our singers.
Excellent job all. Very, 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 very good.
I every year I do this thing where I tell you, for each semester who gets the attention to detail award. It's just, you know, there's an actual award this time, but it's really hard. So many people have just improved so much and grown so much, but there's two people that have been on point every single week, and I want to acknowledge them both. One of them was in our last band. Well, actually, several of them are in all the bands, but one from the last band is Will Easley. Will, congratulations.
Yeah, Will!
Thank you.
Will!
Nice job, and Will.
Easley!
One more. I think it's the first time he's been a guitar player, but Stuart Kim has been...
Woo!
Nice man.
Stuart King!
Every single week, and that is hard to do in this class. So both of you, big congratulations. Amazing, amazing work. Sean, you're gonna be in for a treat with this class. So, you know.
I'm ready for them. I'm ready.
I pass them on to you. I hate to see them go, but I love to see them grow. So, you know, it's all good.
I wanna say thank you to all you guys, and I especially, I know that it's not lost on the students, but for the parents that are listening, you need to know that this faculty is tireless, amazing, relentless in terms of the quality that we want from your young people. We look upon them as being people to whom we can pass the torch. And we've all had to work really, really, really hard. We haven't done it inside of an institution all of the time. So a lot of the things that we're telling them hopefully will save them some years and allow them to be able to grow into the people that they really want to and have their passion and their purpose meet right here. I want to thank the faculty because when we look for a way to continue, I didn't hear any whining. I didn't hear, oh, we're not gonna be able to do this. I didn't hear anything except for, okay, so what do we want to, how should we proceed? What can we do? And shout out to Sean, who had a friend who had something that if we could make it robust enough, it would provide the answers for our students. And then thank you for the students for trusting, because I know that at first it looks like, okay, they're pushing us off this cliff. And we did, but you responded, because we were all figuring out how we were gonna land on the way down. So I really, really appreciate it. And I think that the growth has been remarkable in areas beyond just the music. And some of those areas are some of the most important ones that you don't get to for a little while because you're so focused on trying to get the notes right and everything. But you guys had to do double duty. Get the notes right, get the parts right, be responsible, pass your part on, get it done every single week. We missed no week. You got it all done. You did all of the repertoire that prepares you for the next step. So I'm very, very proud of you, and I'm very proud of the faculty. Parents, thanks for believing. Thanks for hanging in there with us also. And you guys be safe and take care of yourselves. It's been great.
I want to say one final thing, which is this couldn't happen without our leader here, our department chair, Ms. Patrice Russian. We're very fortunate to have her in this class as well. You don't get to have her.
Hey!
Leading the ship in this crazy time. For like as trusting vision that we have for your development and trusting us to go and leap forward with this. So thank you. Amazing job. It's been an amazing semester. I can't wait to see what you guys do for the next year and the rest of your life, your musical life as well.
And guys, I'd love to offer the invitation to come be with us tomorrow for the sophomore class.
Awesome.
Come please email that link or send it in the chat or something.
I'll see if I have that for you.
Did you guys not get it? Do you all need the links for tomorrow is sophomores and Thursday juniors? Does everybody need the link?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Thank you. Somebody just sent some of it. Which is which? That's for sophomores?
They're the same one. They're for the sophomore class.
Okay. What's for the junior class? Anybody have that one yet?
In a moment. Right?
You guys, I think Mike in that same email, they should have sent them out to all faculty.
Yes. Coming right up. He'll beat me to it.
All right. So it'll be the same time. It'll be 4:00, you know, Pacific time, same situation. You're going to really enjoy the sophomore show, I think. And remember that the third year show is all original music. So if you're interested to see what in this modality they came up with, you're welcome to check that out on Thursday. I hear a question?
I don't think so.
Okay. Guys, thank you all so very, very much. Continue to be safe. We'll keep you updated as we know what's going on and what's going to be happening. We look forward to seeing you in the fall.
Thank you.